Here at PJM, we have three main priorities: keeping the lights on, buying and selling energy, and planning infrastructure. PJM's planning process aims to assess and manage the future needs of the electric grid. Consider supply and demand. Supply is considered to be the generation of the system. Demand is considered to be the load from customers. Our planning process aims to ensure there is adequate supply as well as infrastructure to satisfy that demand. PJM's annual long-term planning process evaluates proposed upgrades such as new transmission lines and new substations, new power plants, and neighboring systems. The planning process also identifies opportunities for improvement to ensure and maintain grid reliability and operation, essentially keeping the lights on. We start by assembling a model, and this model will consider future planned upgrades such as new transmission lines or new substations, planned generation additions, as well as future demand projections. Future demand projections are a key input into the model. They represent how much energy is expected to be consumed by people in a particular region over the next 5 years. After the model is assembled, we'll next evaluate the model under various scenarios to stress the system to see if it meets performance requirements. The best way to think about that is to think about a road traffic system. Here you have a residential area and a city area. Residents can take a number of different routes, including a main highway, which is comprised of multiple lanes, or different side roads. Most people will probably take the main road. But you might experience periods throughout the day where the main road is congested, there might be an accident on the highway, and people will diverge to the side roads. But what happens eventually is you do reach times throughout the day where everything is congested and everyone's having a hard time getting from here to there and vice versa. So there are a number of ways you could solve this issue. One way would be to, for example, add an additional side road. Or perhaps adding an additional lane to an existing highway. By doing so, you allow travelers additional ways to get from point A to point B. This concept is transferable to planning. What we do in planning is use a set of criteria which represent performance requirements that are enforceable by entities such as NERC, FERC, PJM, and its respective stakeholders. Using this criteria, we'll identify areas of improvement, and we'll then take proposed upgrades, such as new transmission lines or existing transmission lines, new devices such as reactors or capacitors to provide voltage support, to see whether or not they actually mitigate the issues. Once we verify that they mitigate the issues, they then become part of our plan and will be proposed to be constructed in the future.